Well, Warner, whoever thought that the Lakers would lose four straight to the Pistons?
Well,
are you shocked?
Michelle, this will go down as the what-if series. That's it. I mean, it's too bad.
Yeah.
I mean, I picked the Pistons, big deal, 4-3, but without Magic and Scott, it'll be the what-if series. What if those guys had played?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it's going to take away from the sweep. 105-97, the Pistons win it 4-0. Let's go to the videotape. First half, look at these moves by Worthy, who had 40 points in the game.
Whoa.
There he goes against Sally and Dumars and the two. And watch Cooper now run into Rodman right here. Here it comes, and boom, no foul, and he feeds Worthy. Lakers by 6 at the half, but big play, 7:15 left in the game. Lakers with a chance to cut it to 2, but no, Cooper air ball. Instead of cutting it to 2, it's Vinnie Johnson to Isaiah with 14 and Detroit by 6. A minute left, Dumars MVP, 23 points, and Detroit wins it 105-97, and the Pistons show class, a standing ovation for Kareem in his last appearance. Both the Yankees and Mets played first-place clubs tonight, and they both lost. At Shea, the Cubs beat the Mets 4-2. Ron Darling lost a four-hitter. Let's go to the videotape. The catch of the night. Excuse me. Top of the third. Dunson, line drive, center field. Lenny Dykstra. Excuse me. Get that frog. All right. You want to see a perfect bunt? This made Jeffries 10-20. And then the top of the fifth. Dunston, boom, two-run homer. Ties the game 2-2, two sacrifice flies, 4-2 Cubs. And speaking of Dykstra, look at this. Ejected for arguing on a check swing. The Cubs win it 4-2, so the Mets lose six of the last eight, and four fall back. I've got the frog, and Ernie drinks the water. That's funny.
That's
Mark Langston and the Expo shut out the Cardinals on a four-hitter. The Astros finish 10-1 in the homestand. They trail the Dodgers 3-2 in the seventh. Scott against Valenzuela. Call a doctor. In Baltimore, the first-place Orioles beat the Yankees 5-2. Dave LaPointe, the loser, gave up 13 hits before being taken out in the eighth inning. Let's go to the videotape. Top of the first, Mickey Tettleton, who has 16 home runs on the year, doubles in the left field. Bradley scores 1-0. Then, former Met, Randy Milligan, 3-4, base hit center field. But look at, here comes Barfield Stowe to the plate. Here comes Tettleton. He's out at the plate because he missed the plate. Now, 3-2 Baltimore, bottom of the eighth, and Orsulik went 2-4, doubles over Hall's head. Melvin scores to make it 4-2. Orsulik scores on the grounder 5-2, and that was it. Cleveland won tonight, and Carlton Fisk homered, so he ties Yogi's American League all-time career record for home runs by a catcher. In Boston, the Red Sox beat the Tigers 8-7. Let's go to the videotape. Here's a record. Watch the second base umpire. Four balks in one game by John Dobson ties the American League record. The recovery of the night, Gary Pettis slips, falls, and makes the catch 8-7 Red Sox. Now, as far as the Hearns-Leonard decision, the problem was the inconsistency of that 10-point must system. Nobody ever seems to score a round less than 10-8, even when there's a solid knockdown. All three judges gave Hearns the 10-8 for his two knockdowns. But the judge who scored the fight even gave Leonard a 10-8 for round 12 with no knockdown. After the fight, Hearns joked about his performance.
I think I answered his question tonight, too, about the chin. About the old leg.
The biggest surprise had to be that Hearns, suddenly his chin has gotten stronger, or Leonard's powering punching has gone down. And the starting outfielder for the American League, Jose Canseco. He hasn't played a game all year. This is Warner Wolf.
Ernie? All right, I can have the water. Okay.
Finally, right? Many commuters hope that their next morning rush hour won't be a repeat of the last one. Traffic was a nightmare when the Cross Bronx Expressway turned into a washout. Rainwater backed up because of a broken sewer pump, and that caused two-hour delays clear into New Jersey on the George Washington Bridge and as far away as the Tappan Zee. But tonight, officials say the problem has been cleared up and things look pretty good for the morning.
All right, when we come back, the rain is gone, but Mr. G says we'll be in a fog in the morning. And then get ready for a ride in the real Batmobile. Coming up.
Thanks a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, anytime you want to bring out surprises, just let me
Thanks.
Know.
We'll keep that in mind.
It's good to see those folks here.
I'm sure.